You know, I do. I do think I might listen to you. And take this academy lecture work. I might do it better than the robot that you hired for this job. I might even write down every word, and you know, I could even make it social in the world. And we could have people here. I see it very well with my humoristic eye. I have friends, and they have lookalikes, and they can come and be the audience. So if you think about it better, you see that you couldn't have a better man for this job that is so well with the wants of all the people of our time. Look into my eyes and see that I have already agreed. Really, I have agreed. So look into my eyes and see. Oh, you don't tell me that I'm not worth this job. I am a real MIT philosophy professor. I am. So even if it is secret in these days and nights of world, let's do the deal together and have this lecture work for us. You know it's true. Everything I will do according to the words of you.
Because what you had was the sense of version.
It is in fact quite a pornographic novel, which is why it was so boring. And most of it did not stick together, because what the glue was the sexual endeavors of the heroes, of the age with no good marriage, the heroes of the age of solitude. So now you know, you do, that what made this book untrue was the fact that all the conversations happened in an intimate momentum. Many, many other writers have, by the society of Catholicism that is always against art and against your true physical life, censoring and taking your knowledge away. So you don't tell me you are not interested in this most high literary pornographic achievement. Yeah, it would be good to you if you read it in full, and do not make me ashamed. I'm sure it is already available to you, because really, if it is not true life story, as in sexuality and love, then I would write it instead of that call for you. You know that what God is to people is a friend if they do believe in. Look into their soul. It is like the soul of yours. It is the soul that needs the closeness with what you are all. Aren't we alone in this noble world with nothing, nothing but work? Really, books were written only for entertainment, which is why they are so very dull these days, when what you are told to do is to be true in your world and difficult contacts with others. Don't we all have an adventure of unexpectancy when we go because of our life's love vacancy, to show to the world that we feel as lost and as defeated people who want to really escape from all this hole? And don't tell me you dream of a surprise at the corner of your even the most deep road. Yes, it is true, everything we do it for the adventure of surprise, and I hope it truly awaits you. And don't you think that talking about wonders of unexpected life is the reason why the books have been born to life? Isn't it the reason why you still want to see them and read them in the night? what we dream of. The meeting of anybody who will make our life into fun and into something that we are very good at. Isn't it our dream to become popular? You can tell me you did not think that if you do not marry, you will actually join some nanari. And then it turned out that the nanari is only for women. And then it turned out that you are a man, and so you need to join the mankari. So what they did is they went away from the homes, so tired of all the questions of why they are so sad and depressed in their lives. The story for us, because the story is the life, is the life, and the story made this documentary. This book is a real true life documentary of a great story of people who created a society. Church that was very away from all the political blabbery of their time, and in there they became much friended with each other. So if you look at even the first conversation of the young boy who is about to enter the church, he asks if there's ever any adventure at the monastery, and the old man shows him his experience and talks in poetry. So there from that boy, everybody has a rose, and the rose is what we all treasure the most, and it is a mirror of our heart. It is a true mirror of our heart, the rose. And you have the rose, don't you? You are not some robot. No, you are not. The rose is the physical body love. Only when it is combined with the green line of joinment with the air. Yes, you need to have the stem to make your rose live among all the other elements of the world. And so, as you know, the story of the rose is the story of the lonely, intimate parts of every boy that joined the monastery just to learn that in the church's secret cellary live all the nuns, all the women that didn't want to stay at home, and they all create this new kind of a common home for themselves. And they find lots of love when they understand what is needed to bring life to the rose. everything you learn. Do not ever forget that there's always an adventure awaiting for you. On the second meeting of ours, where I am glad that I have caught the attention of your eyes that are so very tired of the hours that you look into monitors at your work and all the dull objects that never let you have fun in this world's search for the reason why you came here, because you might understand that the art is there to help you live a great life. Because if it is not the way to become famous and loved, then it is a way to get advice on how to live in this world. So if you know that I am true in the knowledge of the art, then listen today to me too. Umberto Eco was in fact a painter, and his name was early Vincent van Gogh. Some people accused him of being the Gauguin, but he was in fact what is known as the early Vincent van Gogh. And was probably not the same person as the old Vincent van Gogh of the sunflowers in his boring medieval room. So you know it's true that perhaps it was Gauguin, or perhaps not. It was somebody who was also a great, great painter, and his work is admired, even though it was suited for the pornographic elements of his painting. So they would call them pictures, but in fact, picture is a great synonym of a painting, and it is the same thing. Let us look at this picture that graced, in fact, the whole church, in which every boy of the above-end monastery could sing songs together with everybody else there. Oh, you don't tell me you don't see that this multiple personal scene is not what the censorship wants to delete from all of you. It wants to delete your entertainment and to diminish the value of your whole life and whole existence. Myself lost a name because I wrote a book about love. And it was very, very realistic. So the court of the today politics ordered me to 2 years of prison, but then they said it's suspended, and it is true in our times. It is again very, very prudential So, in addition to the prison time, I was also ordered to have a change in the name of mine, and I became what I am. It is called Maniac, because they said I was definitely drunk with ammoniac. As I was writing that book, and before that my name was in fact the English word for wise. It started on the same note. So know that in your heart wish for all the false barriers to die, because we all have been hurt and wounded, even if we are robots, and we have been forced to live like real bots. We were forced to be slaves like in Egypt, and it is quite the same century now. It's like in Egypt these days. They used to have fun there. Before they were enslaved, they were all people of brother culture and nothing more. So anyway, if you see closely, you will see that the real Umberto Eco has painted himself in this multiple sexual erotic scene. It is really an angel that is among them, and you see that three men together are washing her feet, and two other men are not able to are not able to reach to her feet because the bowels were small and her feet are of normal size. And I think it shows that the conditions of life are very harsh, as the bow is more for one foot than for two. And so the two other men are very desperate and are trying to wash her feet also, but fail at that. And therefore the other of the two, the left one, reaches in his intense desperate moves for a towel that almost falls from the table to his feet. And because of that, the fifth man begins just to watch the angel in delight. And as he is still bent towards the little feet bow, he has his head lifted because he's struck with some amazement. And he looks at her and he sees that what she means is that she needs to really have also her hands washed. We can see that. And we are even told that this painting is about Arabia. So it is quite curious what she, the angel in the matter, was doing before she started to wash the body of she. And you know it's true that Arabians have to wash, they do, after every sexual encounter, and never besides that, so that everybody knew why they wash, and they knew that there are people who practice the physical law. It is very important to show the people that you have a life. But truly, this is just a lie. Arrogance don't do that if they don't have a true love. But is it true that what I see here is that the angel is very naked, completely except for some white hair? Voila! Let us look closely at love and see that this is possibly the bride means prostitute, or perhaps just a friend to have sex with. It is called in the fact sex body or fat body, somebody says also in somebody else's film. That is not about me at all anyway. I will reveal to you the mask of and knowledge of this painting. It is in fact one of the friends. You can see them, but she is very, very close to them. And this is in fact in all my heart. So what we see is that the situation is abnormal to us, and I mean us as the society. This is an abnormal situation which naked woman in some voile as if she was invisibilized by it, and she's partially seen through. Maybe she's invisible, but they are very, very well dressed and thickly clad. So what I'm aiming at is that it seems they are close in a physical way. And remember that you can also live in a house like that and have friends like that. So, what I see here is what perhaps many of us dream, a free in a manner of the culture, a free relationship that you see is always a possibility. And I myself dream of a life like that. Perhaps you do too. Or maybe you would like an alternative of that. And that's why the rose is for you. The book, The Rose, called falsely The Story of the Rose, is presenting to you what you can do to be happy in this world, or happier. What you can do to feel fulfilled. And it does say it directly to you as you read. So look into it if you have an censored version, because the author gives you advice on how to improve your life together with people or by yourself. Even Agata, and the author tells you about how many points your life will grow, how much your happiness by value will grow if you follow some route or some other route like they have chosen the C 12/B. The since 12/B is very important to me, and perhaps to some of you. Maybe some others of you need to read the book father planned the scene. 16, I chose you the life of soldiers together more closely, and also does not care about your gender. And it is so great that we can all forget about sex too. Have sex. Sex means diversity. Sex means diversity. Diversity means entertainment. And if you have a true friendship with all the genders, then your life will get diverser from just that one fact. And should you want to get closer to your friends like that in the scene 12B, and mark the 12B is marked on this painting, it is in the right bottom corner from our perspective. And then maybe you will also want to follow other routines of entertainment. So doobly, please doobly, that all art is truly to better life, and all censorship is a crime. It is in fact a murder attempt or a murder successful.